here for worship on this warm day. And it's a joy for me always to be back here with some people from the cluster that I have known for the last 30 years or so. So this is nice. We're going to begin with our confession and forgiveness. It's put in our bulletin. And I invite you to stand if you are able and to make the sign of the cross. In the name of the Holy Parent and of the Child, let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not followed your path, but have chosen our own way. Instead of putting others before ourselves, we long to take the best seats at the table. When met by those in need, we have too often passed by on the other side. Set us again on the path of life. Save us from ourselves and free us to love our neighbors. Amen. Hear the good news. God does not deal with us according to our sins, but delights in granting pardon and mercy. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. You are free to love as God loves. Amen. go to Jerusalem. And he sent messengers ahead of him. And the rabbi is going to the Samaritans. What's this or what? Is this what I see? On their way, they entered a village of the Samaritans to make ready for them. But they did not receive him because his face was set. When his disciples James and John saw it, they said, "Lord, do you want us to command fire to come down from heaven and consume them?" But he turned and rebuked them. Then they went back to another village. As they were going along the road, someone said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." And Jesus said to him, "Foxes have holes, and birds of the air have nests. Son of man has nowhere to lay his head." To another he said, "Follow me." And he said, "Lord, let me first go and bury my father." And Jesus said to him, "Let the dead bury their own dead, but as for you, go and proclaim the kingdom of God." Another one said, "I will follow you, Lord, but first let me say farewell to those at my home." And Jesus said to him, "No one who puts a hand to the plow and looks back is fit for the kingdom of God." The gospel of the Lord. So is this mic working all right? Okay, great. Joy for my daughters and son-in-laws and I to get together with her for her birthday. I didn't know what to get her. So I went to Port Grand Richmond and I found some very expensive, but I think quite wonderful things. And I read them on the phone. I wrapped them up for me. And I gave them to her. But I also got her something else. She opened up the ones from Photographs Richmond and she liked them, but you know, it wasn't that exciting for her. But she opened up the other present that I got. And that was one of these, I know some of you probably have them, these little digital frames that you can have photographs loaded on. And then they show up. For almost 50 years, it's hard for me to imagine that. And over the course of those 50 years, I have been blessed to perform over 500 baptisms. It's always one of the most fun part of ministry, is to have a chance to join with the family and celebrate the new life as it begins. Even if it's someone older, even if I'm going to celebrate this. All of them have been really wonderful. Several of those times, one of them, the baby spits up something. maker of all things. Through your goodness, you have blessed us with these gifts, ourselves, our time, and our possessions. Use us in what we have gathered, in feeding the world with your love, through the one who gave himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our care. It was said at all times and in all places, give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death in the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with the choirs of angels, with the church on earth, and with the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending song. With the outcast and the despised, and to ransom those in bondage to prejudice and sin. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup, he gave thanks, and he gave it to the one to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Remember, therefore, his death and resurrection. We await the day when Jesus shall return to free all the earth from the bonds of slavery and death. Come, Lord Jesus, and let the church say amen. Send your Holy Spirit, our advocate, to fill the hearts of all those who share this bread and cup with courage and wisdom to pursue love and justice in all of the world. Come, Spirit of freedom, and let the church say, amen. God, our prayers and praise with your prophets and martyrs of every age, that rejoicing in the hope of the resurrection, and live in the freedom and hope of your Son. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours. Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, we are bold to pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. In Christ's presence, there is fullness of joy. Come to the banquet. These are indeed the gifts of God for you, the very much beloved people of God. The body of Christ is given for you. The blood of Christ is shed.
Thank you.
of those gathered with us at a distance, and send them all who hear your word and feast at your table, with the abiding presence of your beloved child, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Thank you.